Back with another video, and today, as Yaka read by the title already, I am gonna be doing the cat from Alice in Wonderland. I believe his name is Chester, right? I don't know if I'm saying that right, but that's who I'm gonna be recreating today. And I just thought it would be a fun, and this one's a little bit more detailed as far as like the Halloween looks that I have done already on my channel. But I thought we would mix it up a little bit and have a little fun with some color. So for the Chester cat, I've seen a lot of different renditions of Halloween looks and stuff of that nature. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do my own version. But anyways, let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so I'm gonna start my base off with the Elf Poreless Putty primer. I almost forgot, almost called it foundation. And I've used it a couple of times, and I feel like it does help keep your makeup in place. The one thing though that I have to say, that I don't know if it's because I'm using it wrong or what the case is, but it doesn't, I'm over here picking my nose. It doesn't really cover my pores in as much. Well, I thought I put enough. I don't know if you guys have used this primer, because I do like the primer as far as like longevity and everything, but I just have pores around my face right here, and you know, no one wants pores and stuff, you know what I mean? So I don't know if I was just putting too much, too little. Like, do you tap it on there? Should I just try to tap it on there? Or like, you put a whole chunk? I don't know, you know. I don't wanna put too much either. And I'm gonna use this one as my primer for today, just because I do like the longevity of the primer. I think it's a good primer. It's just, I want it, and it, that primer is one of those primers that's been one of those very popular primers that a lot of people fell in love with when it first came out. So that's why I was so excited to like use it. So the fact that like I can't get it to go and to cover my pores, I'm just like, well, that sucks, you know. So we'll see this little technique that I just did. So anyways, enough of that. Now I'm gonna start with a wider base, just because I want the colors to pop. So I'm just gonna go in with my Wet n Wild foundation in a Photo Focus Bronze Beige, and this is what I'm gonna use for my base. And gonna go ahead and just add a little bit on. Oh, I forget what this one have. Comes with a little spoolie, and you guys can literally use a lighter shade if you want, or you can go ahead and just use your regular foundation, because most of your face is have that. Okay, one thing I do have to say really quickly, since I did mention the primer, I feel like it covered pretty much better than last time. So I don't know if it was the foundation, maybe I'm just not using it with the right foundation. I don't know, we'll have to keep that one, you know, getting updated and seeing what I need to do with that. But anyways, okay, so now that I have that on there, I'm gonna go and move on with my eyes. And I'm gonna go in with the Photo Focus concealer in the shade Medium Tawny. And this is the Wet n Wild one. And this one matches a little bit more of my skin tone. So so it's not as bright. I do like a bright under eye. I like to use that to conceal sometimes, if not like for a natural makeup look. But this is gonna be our base for the eyes. And I do have a photo for reference too, because I was trying to get one online and like trying to figure out which one I liked. But a lot of them, honestly, were really cute. But this one just spoke with me, you know? Anyways, I'm gonna go in with my Morphe, AOA Studio F19 brush from Miss A. And I'm gonna go in with my Fenty setting powder to set my eyes, and the shade Butter. Okay, and now what we're gonna go ahead and do, we're gonna go in, dip into the e.l.f. Retro palette and the Sweet Nothings palette from ColourPop. This is an old palette, but it has a beautiful purple shade in there. I know it's kind of messed up, but this beautiful purple over here that we're going to be using. But in the meantime, we're going to go in with the Retro palette in the shade Tropicana, which is this beautiful purple. And that's going to be my transition shade for my eyes. So I'm going to go in with a fluffy brush, and it's going to be the M514 from Morphe. And we're just going to create a smoky eye with that color. We're just going to keep blending color. So right now it's going to be more of a lighter purple. So just keep that in mind. And I'm excited because I'm going to use a new glitter shadows that I got a while back, that I was saving it for this exact reason. So, and for the eyes, basically you just want to go out with any color combo of smoky eye that you want and your color scheme. I'm gonna go ahead and be going in the purple and pink, but also I'm gonna add a pop of blue and see how that looks, just to, you know, make it a little bit more fun. Just want to keep packing that color on there. Next, we're going to go into the Sweet Nothings, and we're going to go in with that purple that I was talking about. Actually, we're going to go in with the shade Tule, which is kind of a deeper shade, so this one right here. And then we're going to go in with that purple, because that purple is really bright. So, just want to deepen it up a little bit more. So, same thing. Blending it out. Putting it in our crease. And you kind of want to be a little bit more dramatic with this smoky eye because, again, it's for a Halloween look. And I'm creating kind of like of a cat wing, you know? I'm kind of referencing back and forth with this photo, but I also, like I mentioned, want to do my own version of it. I'm taking a more precise brush, so I'm 507. Morphe brush as well, and this is just to be more precise on the color. Create that wing a little bit better. See that? So that's the idea as far as the wing. Just a blend, not any harsh edges. We're just gonna keep doing that back and forth until we have it how we would like it, okay? And then next, since we're gonna go ahead and be with pink-ish colors, I am gonna actually, I'm gonna take this purple actually, because I had it out, and it's the Fenty, it's the Fenty Loose Pigment, and this one's called February, which is really cute, because that's my birth month, y'all. And then we're gonna go in with, trying to figure out how exactly I want to add this on. I have an idea. Okay. So I'm gonna go in with my Miss A, AOA Studios E123 brush, and I'm gonna go in with that. Okay, so I'm just wetting that brush, and then going in with the shadow. Shoot, be careful, guys, not to go too much. See how pretty that shadow is? So freaking gorgeous, you guys. Okay, and I'm just gonna drag it all the way right there, because now what we're gonna do, we're gonna add, I'm gonna go in with my just a round fluffy-ish brush. This Gala doesn't have a name. I believe I got this at Ross. And I'm gonna go in with the Retro palette in the shade Spiced. It's more of a red, but I want it to turn more pink with the purple. So we're just gonna use that so it shows up a little bit more, you know? I should deepen it. Like, that's cute, but let's deepen that corner with the on the rise. We're gonna do the exact same thing on the other eye. So now that we have that, with my Wet n Wild little glitter pot, and this is the Wet n Wild color iconic glitter single and bleached, and it's so like these are so like creamy and like, oh, and I'm going in with my Morphe M170 brush, and you literally don't need to wet it because it's literally already creamy. If I want to do it right here, yeah, let's do the whole eye. I wanted to use this one because it's not going to take over the color. And I'm just tapping it on my eye. Gonna go in with my finger. Tap a little bit more in the center. See how that looks? Same thing with the other eye. The Fenty Vivid Liquid Liner in the shade Techno Beat. Beautiful bright pink color. We're gonna use to line the top area of that crease. Area always like anyways, we're gonna go in with the blue one, and this one is gonna be in the shade Hot Tub Club. Gonna be just like a regular liquid liner. But it's definitely gonna give it a pop. Now we have that done. Now we're gonna go ahead and move on to the brows. Hold on, I need to put my hair up. It's really bugging me. I'm gonna put it up anyways because my hair's gonna be used more as like the tail of the cat, you know. And I would go in with colored paint, but I don't have any. But that's besides the point right now. Okay, so what we're gonna do with our brows, I'm gonna do them regular, except I'm gonna go in with just a regular angled brush, which is gonna be the EcoTools and angled liner. And I'm gonna go in with that shade Mousse in the palette in the ColourPop Sweet Nothings. And we're gonna literally line them like they regular brows. Okay, so I think that looks pretty good. So next, what we're gonna go ahead and do, we're gonna go in with that blue. Underline the bottom of it. only the bottom. Color Icon palette or little pot, and this one is in Spiked, and it's this beautiful silver, and I'm gonna go in again with the same flat edge round brush, and this one's the M178 brush. Okay, this is gonna go right on top of her brows, so we're gonna brush it on there. Literally like that. On some lashes just so you have the eyes almost done. Now I'm gonna go in with the same concealer that I used to prime my brow, my eyes, and I'm going in to conceal. I guess let's go ahead and finish the eyes. I'm gonna go in with my Lancome Drama Liquid Pencil. I can never pronounce the names of the Lancome eyeliners, but it's a beautiful purple color. The color actually got Rouge, I believe it's what it was called, but it's, you can literally get whatever purple you have on hand. I'm using this one because it's what I found first. And you're just putting it in the lower line. It doesn't have to be perfect because you are going to smudge it out. Brush and same on the rise. I'm gonna and then I'm gonna go in with the Retro palette in the shade Disco, and it's a purple shimmer. Much fun. Okay, now that I have that on there, I'm gonna go in with the silver shade, which was again called Spiked, and I'm gonna go in with the more precise rounded edge brush. It's gonna be the Morphe E36 brush, and it's just to grab onto that shadow, and then we're gonna put it right in the center of the lid. Same thing with the other eye. Bring it up a little bit. Just so it blends in with everything nicely. You guys can see that. love how much glitter I have. Okay, so now for the nose, let's go ahead and get that started. Basically just gonna be like a little heart. So with the blending brush, I'm gonna go in with the ColourPop palette in the shade Mousse. And we're just gonna create like a V, or almost like a heart. So now what we're gonna do is take that liquid liner, the blue one, we're gonna line it. As best as we can. And then just we're gonna let that dry, and while that dries we're gonna start doing the little cat whiskers, I believe. Not whiskers, but cat like you get what I'm saying. And so we're gonna go in with, let's go ahead and use this brush again just because it's really little, in the same shade Mousse. I'm just like rough drafting it. I think that's only the room that I have. I'm gonna create little ones. I did not realize that my camera did something and it wasn't recorded, but basically what I was doing was filling in with the same shade the little stripes in that color. And basically now what I'm going to go ahead and do, I'm going to take this brush right here, because it's a really big brush, it's going to help me disperse the product even faster and more of the product, I mean. And this is the AOA Studio High Def brush in F8 from Miss A, and I'm going in with the shade Disco. And I am just gonna go ahead and go in with the blue liquid liner again and line the square. To do the mouth. Now, same shade Mousse from ColourPop, and what we're gonna do, we're gonna line it with this tip felt brush. It's from, I got this from Walmart, from the craft section. They work really good, so what I decided to get. I'm gonna make the mouth all the way over here and go all the way down. And then, and you're using your lips as a guide. So I actually, something happened with my camera again, but I basically went back and I used, decided to use this liquid lipstick from Kat Von D Beauty, and this is in the shade Vampira, and it's a really dark purple, and I felt like it would be perfect for shading it in. So I'm usually just going in the areas where it should be dark. Like I mentioned, I went off camera and I actually went with my concealer instead because I just felt like it was gonna, you know, blend out better. But I would suggest you get a better liquid white shade liner or whatever it may be, because that one was not working for me. I went in with the Miss A really small rounded edge brush, and the F18 from AOA. And then of course I went back with my Vampira shade to outline. And now we're gonna go ahead and do the whiskers. So we're gonna go ahead and grab the glitter again, and with our finger, we're gonna add like a little dot right there. Does not have to be perfect. Come up real quick. Okay. And next, with the blue liquid, yes. The whiskers. Cute. And then we're going to create a little dot. Single brush, which is the Morphe M431, and we're gonna go in with the mousse. Same thing with the other side. I should outline the whiskers. Gives it a little bit more dimension. Okay, you guys, so I went off camera and I decided to put this white glitter shadow on my teeth just so they became more white, and I feel like it made the look a little better in my opinion. But it's the shade Sea Salt in Retro Paradise. Alright you guys, so this is the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I did. I had so much fun creating these beautiful bright Chester Alice in Wonderland cat. It was so fun to create, and I just hope you guys enjoyed it. And like always, don't forget to subscribe and share and like. I greatly appreciate you for all the support that you've shown me. I thank you and I love you. Until next time, bye.